I'm Dr. Daniel Kantor, and I'm president of the Florida Society of Neurology. Like we said, the meeting at the Consortium of MS Centers is made up not just of lectures, but also of posters. And at the last meeting, at the American Academy of Neurology meeting, we had the opportunity to talk to Dr. Mark Friedman. Well, here's a poster from his group. What it did was it looked at one of the invisible symptoms of multiple sclerosis. In MS, there's really visible symptoms like walking, and then there's invisible ones like cognition or thinking, and other ones like pain. A lot of times those can be the most frustrating because people might say, oh, you have MS, but you look so good. And so what this poster looks at, it looks at the idea of cognitive reserve. What cognitive reserve means is that even before there is some cognitive decline, if somebody already has better cognition, so somebody has already better reasoning and already better ways of doing things mentally, it can protect them a little bit later in life. Now, we've seen a similar thing in the study of the nuns with Alzheimer's dementia. So a separate question than multiple sclerosis, but remember, one of our goals is to learn from each other. And we know that in the world of dementia, we think that exercising the brain makes sense. Just like we go to batting practice and we practice batting the ball, just like we go to physical therapy, just like we do all these sorts of things, there may really be good reason to exercise the brain. See you soon.